Hello, test. Hi everyone, my name is Grayson. Welcome to my channel. I make videos about architecture and engineering. I am a fourth year at the University of Texas at Austin, so that's just like a little bit about me. If you're interested, I would love if you subscribe, maybe like the like button and share with your friends. Anyways, let's get into the video. So this video is going to be all about my first studio project in my first advanced studio. So like the way UT does it is your first 3 years, you're in the foundation and intermediate sequence, and then after you pass portfolio review, you get to go into the advanced sequence, which is kind of fun, free for all. They're like supposed to be like super cool or whatever. Anyways, so my first studio project, it's all about how everything is alive. Like, all objects are alive, all buildings are alive, and they have personalities and feelings, and we can form relationships to them, and they can form relationships between each other. So our task was to pick like 3 to 6 objects and then make like a short stop motion video about them. I'm back. Is this piece of concrete. Like, we were doing compression tests on concrete, and then like afterwards we just got to keep like the remains. The concrete is young but mature, dutiful, a life of service, because, you know, he's only like a year old, and he served his purpose. His purpose was to break, and that's him now. And he wears his scars as a badge of honor. So he's kind of like, got me like a lone soldier type vibe, so that's him. This adapter for like, so you can plug into like US, Canada, and EU, I think. That's kind of pretty cheap. He's international. He's pretentious. He's overconfident. There's only been one place I've used him like once. He wasn't even that good. He barely stayed in the wall. Next up, we have this guy, which is my ghost Rubik's Cube. Kind of fun. I have a conflicting relationship with this guy. He was a gift, and he's only a 3x3, and I know how to solve a 3x3 Rubik's Cube. Because it's like so angular and weird, it's very hard to solve. He's really snarky and sarcastic, manipulative, and we don't get along very well. He's kind of an asshole. And then lastly, I have this rock that I found in the parking lot. He doesn't really know the other objects. Like, I just literally picked him up off the ground like a couple days ago. He's had a rough life. Like, where did this guy come from? Like, he came from a mountain somewhere and he went, got here, probably in Colorado. He probably came from Colorado, came down the Colorado River. Was probably in a river for a really long time, and that's how he got so smooth. And then somehow, he ended up miles away from the river and in my parking lot. So he's had a long, rough life. He's old and weathered and stoic. He's a sad object. Hey guys, it's 10 a.m. and Today we're making a stop motion. Okay, cute story. So I realized I can't make the stop motion and make this video at the same time. So I'm just gonna explain to you what I'm doing and then I'll show you the clip. So I need a shot of me walking in from that door back there and coming into this room. And I made one earlier and it was like really shaky. So I'm gonna put it on this like rolling cart thing and I'm just gonna like tape it to that book. It's been like another hour and a half. Got Taylor Swift on. My phone's about to die though, so hopefully I can charge it. Oh my god, so shaky. Hopefully I can charge my phone before the sun gets too weird. Okay, so I'm done filming all the clips, and now it's just a matter of putting it in Premiere and hoping it all fits. Also, I was just kind of throwing all the crap on my bed, so I gotta clean that up now. The video is kind of about the intersection of old and young, of wise and naive. So the rock and the concrete have this solemn maturity to them, while the adapter and the Rubik's Cube kind of have this overconfident arrogance to them. And then in the end, the smooth rock like looks up the adapter and the Rubik's Cube on Amazon and like is gonna like replace them. So it's also about the intersection of like uniqueness and also like mass production. Sometimes like the flashy things that are more mass produced are less valuable than maybe the uglier things that are, you know, unique, and they have a more complex and rich story. Basic materials versus like something that's very like mechanically complex. Kind of just like exploring those things and then exploring them in the personalities of these objects. So this is what I came up with in the end. Watching. I hope you had a fun time. I hope that this was interesting to people. I'll probably be filming more of these little projects and maybe vlogging my final project for this semester. Thanks for watching. Like it if you liked it, share with your friends, and subscribe if you want to. Thanks. Bye.